Hey, what's going on, everyone out there? It's your boy Junish, and now tuning to Starving You. Hope all is well for everyone, and that y'all are blessed. Thank you for being here with me in this moment. Please remember to subscribe, like the page, and share with others. Also, check out my new webpage, which is starvingyou.net, where you can check out my content and more. Based on the instrumentation, you already know who we're going to be talking about today. Yes, the girl Queen Bey, Miss Beyonce. Let the beehive swarm. Let's go. Yeah, so Beyonce was born September 4th, 1981. That makes her a Virgo. The sign of Virgo begins from August 24th to September 22nd. She's an earth sign. Earth signs consist of Capricorn, Taurus, and Virgos, which are compatible with water signs, which are Pisces, Cancers, and Scorpio. They complement each other very well. You can think of this as the water nourishing the earth. Virgo is ruled by the planet Mercury. Mercury also rules Gemini. This planet is all about expression and communication. Which you can see with Beyonce, she's not afraid to express herself and speak her mind, especially in her music. The image associated with Virgo shows a woman that possesses wings. These wings represent chastity, meaning purity, which is kind of funny because when people talk about Virgos, they always say Virgos are the perfectionists of the signs, you know what I mean? And that purity, perfect, perfection, you know, it kind of goes together, right? But we all know no one's no angel. When it comes to signs, certain signs suit other genders more than the other. And when it comes to Virgos in particular, they compliment the women more than they do the men. And that's no disrespect to the men that are Virgos. Okay, let me explain. Female Virgos are very sweet, but at the same time, they could be very strong, especially if there's other women around. They always show their presence and they have this energy about them where they express like they're the boss in the room around other females. As for the male, they're also strong too, but they absorb a lot of that Virgo energy. So when you come around a Virgo male, they don't always come off of that alpha-like energy. They're more beta. Not to be disrespectful or anything like that. It's just something that I've observed over time. You know, you won't see a lot of Virgo men that are leaders per se. Don't take offense to it, all right? Being that Beyonce's an earth sign, that means she's very practical, grounded, and someone that's very dependable. Out of all the signs, earth signs are the most dependable, very consistent. Earth signs are known for being like the slowest out of all the signs, but with Virgos though, they're a mutable sign, and mutable signs possess a lot of versatility and they can adapt to multiple situations. So they're much quicker and maneuver better than like a Taurus or a Capricorn. But because of this, they can lack some kind of inconsistency, but not too much inconsistency because they're still an earth sign. Like I said, Beyonce being a Virgo, this means she's very practical. And with earth signs, they're the type, they have to see it to believe it. So if they accomplish something, it's kind of like if somebody's done it before, so they could see it as something tangible, like, oh, okay, if they did it, I could do it. All I gotta do is work hard and put in the effort. And with Virgos, and earth signs in general, they're very hard workers, and they'll apply a lot of work. They eat work for like lunch, breakfast, dinner, do it all over again, over and over again, you know what I mean? And anybody knows earth signs, you know what I'm talking about. Being that Beyonce's an entertainer, you know she takes that work ethic into a whole other level, you know? And plus she associates Virgo, which is a sign of perfection. Lord only knows, man. she's probably very difficult to deal with because her work ethic is so crazy and her drive, and she probably works very hard, and she probably expects other people that's around her to work with the same intensity and the same level. And the way she is, she's like, hey, if I can do it, they could do it too, so why can't they keep up? She probably drives those around her really crazy, but hey, it's Queen Bey, man, you know what I'm saying? So you gotta respect the highness and do your thing. That doesn't mean she's not very loving. When it comes to female Virgos, they're very loving, very generous. And I'm sure Jay-Z gets everything and anything from Beyonce. And also with female Virgos, they're very loyal. And you can see that Beyonce's been with Jay-Z through thick and thin, and she's held them down through all these years that they've been married. Because of this quality, she can be taken advantage of, and if this was the case, she would feel a lot of pain and hurt, but at the same time, she would probably blame herself and feel like maybe she didn't do something right in the relationship. You know what I mean? But eventually she used to wake up and realize, nah, the person is just treating me like dirt. Then after that, they're just like, all right, I'm out. Peace. Virgos are earth signs and they represent the physical, the materialism. And that doesn't mean Beyonce is materialistic, like she wants 10 cars, 20,000 chains, but she does like to live comfortably and she keeps herself in the know. Like if something's out or something's new, she'll probably be curious about it and maybe buy one of it and just to be in the know and have it. They like nice things, that's just what it is. You know, they're all about what they could see and touch, earth signs. And also they like the sense of having a title, of having some kind of importance, like, you know, being a doctor, a teacher, or something, or a businessman. They like that kind of title. Being that she's like, you know, the biggest of them all in hip-hop, I mean in R&B, and she's dating somebody that's the biggest of them all in hip-hop, which is Jay-Z, you know, it suits her needs. You know, she won't really settle for less. Which is interesting, because when you do see a Virgo, most Virgos usually are accomplished, you know what I mean? And they have a lot of drive, you know, they could be very ambitious. Also, another thing, Beyonce and her being a Virgo and being in the music industry, it really suits her, because one thing I've noticed about Virgos personally, I have a lot of friends that are Virgos, they really have a great ear for music, you know, like for some reason, like, and it's crazy, like, and they're very diverse with their music taste too. It's like they have this old soul about them where they like old school music, but at the same time, they know how to keep it modern too. And you can see that diversity of Beyonce and how she sings and how she has like this old soul thing about her, but she knows how to switch it up and use instrumentations like this in the background, you know what I mean? She's like always changing and evolving. And it's a great thing, and it compliments her and her sign very well. And we can't forget that she's a mutable sign and that helps with her versatility. And because she's a perfectionist, any kind of beat or instrumentation you give her, she'll kill it, you know what I mean? And execute it all the way. Make it seem like, you know, it was effortless. Also, Beyonce, she does have a very strong voice. And this is because Virgos rule the solar plex area right below the diaphragm. And when they express themselves, you know, they take it in from there, all that energy, and then they just give it their all. And you can see it like Amy Winehouse, Michael Jackson, Jennifer Hudson, just to name a few who are Virgos. And also, I remember one time I approached this lady. She told me she was an opera singer. And I automatically assumed, oh, she's probably a Taurus, because Taurus do rule the verb, like Adele. But she was like, nah, she's actually a Virgo. And I was like, oh, okay. And then that's when it clicked. I'm like, all right, yeah. Virgos rule the solar plex area, so that would make sense. And she did. And when I told her that, she was like, that's funny, because most of her co-workers who work with her, that's opera singers, are Virgos. So yeah, there's something there, right? Oh, yeah, speaking about Michael Jackson, that's one of Beyonce's major influences in the music industry. Okay, enough of talking about Virgos. I guess I'm a little biased because most of my friends are Virgos, so I kind of went in a little bit. But let's get to her birth date. She was born on the 4th of September. This number 4 is represented by the planet Uranus, which rules Aquarius. So it has an air quality to it. It's also a feminine number with a feminine energy. But esoterically, this 4 also represents like your inner being, like this inner consciousness within you, which is ruled by like a man when you see it like in a tarot card. So even though it has this feminine energy, but there's things about it that's very domineering and very very strong, you know, where it kind of plays both roles. Kind of confusing, I know how to explain it, but the more you get in tune with what I'm talking about, you'll see what I mean. Okay, to explain this card a little better, you see a king sitting on his throne. But we all know, there's no such thing as a king without a queen. And a queen has a very strong influence on his king. You know, behind every great man is a greater woman, as they say. So this is where you see this duality of the feminine energy, but you see a masculine person sitting on his throne. Being that Jay-Z and Beyonce are both born on the 4th, you see this perfect balance. And also with the number 4, you can see this with nature, dealing with air, fire, earth, and water, how they're in harmony with each other within the world. But on the flip side, it could be very disastrous and things could just go left and it could destroy everything. So this four is very unpredictable, and people that are born the fourth and they're single, they're the type that could have this unpredictable thing about them, could be very destructive. So it's good if they have somebody with them to kind of keep them balanced, because it is a very intense number, you know what I mean? And need something to soothe it down. Remember what I said about Beyonce being an earth sign? Her being a Virgo and her being born in the fourth complement each other very well, because the number four is very disciplined, it's very loyal, very practical, like an earth sign. Very methodical and all about money as well. So you see that compliment there. But on the flip side of the number four, in its negative aspect, you know, Beyonce has to be careful, because she could come off very moody, very rigid, harsh, you know, if things don't go her way. So the people that are around them have to embrace themselves for that, you know what I mean? And, you know, be able to take it in and understand where it's coming from. Because like you said, Virgos are very, you know, they're perfectionists. And Virgos are known for telling it how it is, you know what I mean? They don't have no problem doing that, especially when they're pushed to a certain point. So with that aspect of her being a Virgo and a four, it plays two different dualities. It could be a very positive duality in her life and a negative duality. But for the most part, the four is very positive in her life. And another thing, remember what I said about the four, how it represents the emperor like a king. And you can see this persona with Beyonce, with like these songs that she had. Like she had a song that was called Bow Down. I'm not even gonna say the rest of that. And she also had this other song called Diva. You know what I mean? And it was like the female version of The Hustler. And you see how she portrayed herself in that video, like barely up there, like you can't really touch her. So in reality, that's kind of the persona of the four, you know, being that king, that empress, you know, both of those. I did do a video not too long ago about Jay-Z and explaining the 444, and I related it with him and Beyonce. So you could definitely dive into that, check that video out on my YouTube channel so you can get more information about the four. Okay, so now we're gonna get into Beyonce's life path number. The life path number is pretty much an overview of one's life. So it's gonna deal with the challenges, the opportunities that you may face, you know, within your lifetime. Okay, so now we're gonna begin. Beyonce was born September 4th, 1981. You know me, I like to start off the year first. 1 plus the 9 is 10. 10 plus the 8 is 18. 18 plus the 1 is 19. Now we add that 19 with her birth date, which is a 4, and that gives you 23. 23 now with the month she was born, which is a 9, is 32. Now you break the 32. The 3 plus the 2 is 5. Her life path numbers are 5, which is kind of crazy because her husband's number, Jay-Z, his life path number is also a 5. So you see that compatibility with their life path number and their birth date. Interesting. Also, they're both mutable signs. So all those compatibilities. It's crazy how the universe works, especially if you do the right thing. Beyonce being the life path number 5, it's really a good thing. It complements her very well. The number 5 is ruled by the planet Mercury. It's a masculine number. Also, remember what I said about Virgos, how they're also ruled by the planet Mercury as well. Not to mention, her birthday being a 4 is an air sign. It's ruled by Aquarius, right? And the number 5 is ruled by Gemini. Air signs get along very well, so Aquarius and Gemini get along very well. So you see this complement, you see how all of this intertwine and makes her very balanced. And speaking about balance and being well balanced, when you add Beyonce's 4 plus the 5 for her life path and her birthday, it equals 9. And 9 is a wholesome number. And it's a number about being humanitarian, it's very generous, someone who's competitive, someone who's strong-willed. And you can see that with Beyonce in her life, you know, that represents her. So when you combine those two together, this is how she walks through life in that perfect, harmonious way. Okay, so now let's get back to her life path being a number 5. The number 5 is all about change and adventure. So even though Beyonce is an earth sign, I said like earth signs are very practical, but with Beyonce, you can see that she's always evolving, she's always changing. And you can see this with like different songs that she's made throughout the years. You know, she made a song called Formation, which was caught people off guard. And like I said earlier, she made that song called Bow Down, which was like, oh wow, this ain't Beyonce. But in reality, who's to say what she is? And what, you know, she's ruled by the 5, so it's very unpredictable. It's very creative. It's a creative number. And also remember when she came out that first visual LP, Beyonce, you know, that caught people off guard as well. So you see how this 5 works. You know, it's always unexpected and always different and always creative in a good way. And we all know that Beyonce is probably one of the hardest working people in the industry. But being that her life path is a number five, and like I said, it's all about adventure, you always see that she always makes time for her husband or family, and she travels here and there, you know, through pictures and stuff like that, from what I've seen anyway. So she keeps that freedom within her, because five's like freedom, and this is where she could find the inspiration to even write and talk about other things, you know, she needs that peace of mind. And one last thing, being that life path numbers are five, she knows how to sell herself and be very marketable. Fives are very stylish. And remember, they're ruled by Gemini, so they could be out there with their style. You know, you see her different outfits and how crazy they are and how beautiful they are, even though it's different. And you can see this five with Gemini relating with like Andre 3000, Prince, Tupac, you know, how their style was. So, you know, something to point out, you know. Also, her being a five, she possesses a lot of attraction, a lot of sex appeal. The People magazine did say she's one of the most beautiful women ever. And Complex also said she's one of the hottest singers. So, there must be some truth to that five vibration. Alright guys, thank you for tuning in. I really appreciate it. I hope you guys enjoyed the content. Yes, did it for the Virgos out there. Virgo season has begun. Beyonce. definitely stay tuned. Like the page, share with others, subscribe. And remember, always, let your inner light shine.